Intel has recently revealed that a large number of its processors are affected by a security vulnerability. Millions of Intel-based laptops and desktops are at risk. If you would like to know whether your machines are affected by this vulnerability, you can use the following method using Lansweeper. So what we're going to do using Lansweeper is to use the deployment module to run Intel's discovery tool, which will write a registry entry. Using Lansweeper, we will scan for that registry entry, and then lastly, we will report based on the output of that registry entry. Okay, so first things first, we'll set up the file and registry scanning, as the deployment package will afterwards automatically scan for this value, so this needs to be set up first. So we'll go to scanning, file and registry scanning, and we're going to click add registry scan. These are registry keys made by the Intel tool. And we'll be checking for the value called system risk. Click OK and that's set up. Now the next step will be to set up the deployment package. First we'll check though if we have a package share user account ready, because we will be making use of the package share. Now here I already have a local account set up using my default package share. By default, when you install Lansweeper, it uses the program files Lansweeper package share folder for this. The package itself will download from the Lansweeper forum, as well as the package dependencies. Now here we've already downloaded all the required files. The zip file from the Intel websites, the XML file from the forum, as well as the VBS file from the forum. We're gonna open the zip file and grab the discovery tools folder. We're going to place this directly under the package share folder. And then the next step is to grab the VBS scripts and to place that directly in the discovery tool folder. Now back to the web console. We're going to go to the deployment tab. We're going to click the import button and we're going to browse to the XML file we've downloaded from the forum and then click OK. Now this deployment package will automatically scan the computer. After the package has run successfully, it'll rescan the computer automatically, which will automatically scan for that registry value we've got set up. We're going to be running the package by clicking the Deploy Now button. If you want to do a quick selection of all your assets, you could use the default group, which contains all of your Windows computers. And since the package checks for Intel processors, it will not be deploying needlessly on computers that are not potentially vulnerable. And we'll click OK. And the package is now running.
After starting the deployment, we can check the status of this deployment by going to the installer logs page, where you can see whether everything went all right. And afterwards, we'll be able to check the results of our deployment by adding a new report. We can do so by going to reports, create new report. We'll be posting the report on the forum, which you can find in the description below. So you can just copy paste the report.
Give your report a nice title.
And click save and run and verify the results.
And now in the results we can see whether a computer is vulnerable, whether it's not vulnerable because it's already been patched, whether it's not vulnerable because it has a CPU that's not affected. For instance, fifth generation i5s are not affected. And you could also get outputs regarding detection errors, but this will be because it's a virtual machine. Now once you know which system is vulnerable, you'll need to patch them. And patching them will depend on the manufacturer of your motherboards. Intel has provided a list of vendor links, which you can find in the description as well as in the forum post. Once everything's been patched, you can run the deployment package again to verify whether everything went okay. If you have any further questions, you can use the links in the description to visit the forum post in which we'll be describing the procedure in detail.